My name's David Wrighton. I'm a veterinary officer in the Department of Primary Industries and Regional Development, working in the Animal Welfare Policy Division. What I wanted to demonstrate to you today is the correct method of suturing quite significant shearing wounds. So we've got a deceased sheep, and we are just explaining common areas for the areas where shearing wounds can actually occur. Can occur under the armpit, under the areas of the abdomen, the pizzle area, and also in the hamstrings as well as the neck. We've opened the area up to reveal the underlying, what we call fat, and we haven't entered the muscle layer at this present time. We're going to now clean that wound and using an antiseptic solution. Now this can be in the form of a registered antiseptic, or it can be simply used with salt water, and that's like a tablespoon of salt to a pint or a liter of warm water. Mix it together, that acts as a good antiseptic. Spray that wound to clean it, and our hands are dirty as well, so ideally we should be as well spraying our hands. The needle and thread should be in forms of methylated spirit. So anything like a little small container be given to you with it, at least that makes it a clean stitching technique as possible. Take the first layer of skin on the side, put through the needle, which is the shearer's needle or S-shaped needle, also known as a post-mortem needle, with the thread, which is going to be an extra strong cotton. And you'll see at the end of that thread, we also have a knot already placed, enabling the suture material not to run through the skin. Place through the first layer of skin and the second area of the skin, and we're going to bring the two edges together and then simply do a one single throw. Bring it together and then do another throw. Bring it together, and finally a third throw, and bring it together. That area is now tight for us to continue the procedure. So we're going to cut that last obsolete section of cotton material and continue it, the actual suturing method. The important factor is not to go too wide. If you go too wide, it'll lose the strength of the suture itself, and you're more likely to get wound breakdown. You should only be taking it only around about 2, maximum 3 centimeters away from your original suture. Otherwise, the strength of that stitching will not be as strong. Take the needle, go again, grab the other end of the skin, pop it through. Repeat the process again. The procedure will take slightly longer than you might have deemed necessary, but it will ensure the strength of the wound with this form of running stitch. Make sure those two edges are coming together neatly. And we're not pulling too tight, we're pulling reasonably tight, just enough for that you shouldn't get it to come up bulging, otherwise you're going to be causing more inflammation. So we put in this is the final one, pulling it through, and this time instead of pulling tight, we're going to allow a little bit of looseness in that final loop. And the reason why we're going to be doing that is to allow us to do that final knot, and that final knot is going to be the important one. So we go left over right, forming a little throw, pull tight, left over right again, pull tight, and a final one as well. And finally, once we finish that knot, We take the scissors and cut. This procedure at the moment is done without any pain relief. We're hoping that the product will be utilized at the same time as we spray the antiseptic that will contain pain relief, and that you will finish the shearing of the sheep first before finalizing the actual stitching method. Once we finish this layer of suturing and the wound is now clean, it's important that we disinfect that area using a form of antiseptic spray. And we've got one here, an antiseptic spray. We just cover that area to obviously prevent any potential bacterial infection. We could also use a fly repellent around that area or a combination to prevent anything, any fly strike. The animal should also be effectively marked clearly in order to monitor the healing process of the wound itself.